Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to the Pixel Lab. I want to show you a quick tutorial on how to add two different textures to opposing sides of an object with Octane for Cinema 4D. So let's jump in, and I'm going to throw in a little studio scene just to get us started. I'm going to use the dramatic scene from our Octane lighting essentials, and we'll fire that up. All right, so we're going to use a plane to demonstrate this. We'll just rotate this 90 and scale it down a little bit. So first thing we're going to do is make a regular old diffuse texture. And instead of putting an image in our texture slot, what I like to do is twirl this down and go to C4D Octane and put in an image texture. And if we do that, we're gonna get a bunch of different options that are a little bit more powerful than just putting a texture right in here. So in the image texture, let's put a card and let's apply this to our plane. So let's create one more texture. Actually, this scene is pretty hot, so let's go to our options for our dramatic scene and kick the power down a little bit. Make sure our focus is looking good. All right, so let's duplicate this texture and let's jump into the image texture for the second one. And let's put the back side of that card. We'll pick a nice purple color and we'll put that on here as well. So in the regular Cinema 4D, what you would do is take both materials and put them on here, and then you would change one of them on the side from both. You change it to front or back, and then you could see both of the materials, one on one side and one on the other. So if we spin this around, on the left side of your screen, you can see the Cinema 4D portion actually looks perfect, but in Octane, it's not recognizing that, which can be pretty frustrating. So we're gonna talk about how we can apply this properly. So let's delete both of these, and instead of that, let's make a material and then put in a mix material. Let's open up our mix material, and in the two slots, let's drag the two cards that we've already made, the front and the back. And then we'll take this mix material and let's put it on our plane. So you can see both of these textures now, they're kind of blending into each other using a float slider. So you can basically see 50% opacity on both of them. So if we go into our node editor, you can see that we're mixing these two with a float texture, and that is not what we want. Instead, we want to define the two sides, and we're going to do that with a side node. So the side node is one of the green ones here, right here, side, or you can search for it, side node, and we'll drag that into here. Now our side node only has invert as an option. That's all it has. So basically what it's going to do is take one of your textures and put it on one side of the normals, and then take the other one and put it on the other side of the normals. So this is based on the direction of your normals in your object. So we're going to drag this into the amount, and then we should see a perfect result here. So it doesn't look right on the left, but if we look at the Octane side, now we're interpreting both of these textures perfectly. So this is looking really good. If we want to just invert that, we can do that with the invert and we can swap them around. So that's the side node for Octane, a very useful little node to know about, and I hope that's useful. Thanks as always for checking out the Pixel Lab. Talk to you next time.